Hi everybody, today Mephis and I want to show you what happened in the latest snapshot, 18W32.8 that got released today. It was mostly about bug fixes, but we also got a minor addition. We got 10 new coral types. So now if the corals don't have any water support anymore, they would, like the normal coral blocks, now also die after a while. I think this is also 60 to 100 ticks like the coral blocks. You can also get those dead corals by silk touch mining them like the normal corals. Alright. Then let's continue with the bug fixes. So the first fix was a fix where cows didn't drop cooked steak if they were killed by lava or fire in certain circumstances. But we found out there's still a chance that those cows here would drop raw beef. Sometimes they drop steak, but sometimes they don't. Just need to wait until get one probably. So there we go. Got some raw steak. I picked this up. Got 11 cooked steak and 2 raw beef.
Also, you will be able to see this in the video. The cow did not really take any fire damage right there. It suffocated.
Suffocated? In what?
Yep.
Lava, huh?
Yeah, there is nothing it can suffocate in, but it did not take fire damage.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Look at this, it doesn't take fire damage. And it's going to drop raw.
There was no sizzling sound yet. It was a bit weird.
This wasn't on flames.
Alright, then next we got some performance improvements. I think they were a little bit vague about it, so we don't know exactly what got improved. But we think the water update situation got improved. So this was shown by Gnemon in his latest video, that water in 1.13 was about 15 times laggier than in 1.12, and probably needs more testing, but it looks like, at least client side, that the water updates got improved again. Alright, but we're not 100% sure if that's really it. Then another observer issue got fixed, so the behavior is also back to 1.12 again. If you have a setup like this, where you would power the piston here from the top observer and then 2 game ticks later from the bottom. So in total you got a 4 game tick pulse. You would expect the piston to extend and retract since it's powered for 4 ticks. And it's also the case again, in the previous version the piston was short pulsed. Alright, just an update order issue and this is fixed. Next one, you're now able to bone meal grass underwater and get seagrass. Apparently this didn't work before. Then you can also now place conduits without any water. And there's a new crafting recipe. So like with the sandstone slabs and stairs, you can now use purple pillars in order to craft purple slabs and also purple stairs. All right, then we also got 2 Yama bugs fixed. Maybe Mephits want to explain it.
Okay, so the first bug was you could just keep on feeding them hay bales, even though they were already in larva mode, if they're already tamed. And then the second bug was if you had 2 tamed llamas and you fed them hay bales and you accidentally clicked them too much, the server tried to mount you on the llama, and therefore it flips you around in the direction the llama was looking, which was super obnoxious, and they got finally fixed.
Yeah, Mephits remembers this. From my own experience, I think he bred about 500 Yamas in survival. That was quite annoying.
Terrible.
Alright, then one last change I want to mention. The chunk command that was introduced in the last snapshot now also works remotely. So I got a chunk about 500 blocks over there, which I can now chunk force load, so we got a little comparator clock in there that powers a command block that says that the chunk is loaded. Previously we had to go there in order to load the chunk to prevent it from being unloaded, but now it loads itself. If I do the chunk unforce command, should also have here, it still protects the chunk from being unloaded from the autosave every 900 ticks. So if you do the save all, then it really gets unloaded. Alright, those are all the snapshot news we found out. Thanks a lot for watching. See you in the next one. Bye bye.
Bye bye.